Today we're going to do a durability test on the iPhone 6 Plus. These are the same type of practical durability tests that you've seen in some of my other videos, tests that can relate to everyday life. First off, we'll see how the back of the phone holds up against sharp objects. Now, common sense dictates that if you scratch your phone with something sharp, it'll leave a mark, and this is indeed the truth with the iPhone 6 Plus. The redeeming quality, though, is that if the object is not sharp, like keys or coins, the marks can just be rubbed off, as you can see here. I can just take my finger and rub off the soft marks from the keys that I was scratching the phone with, and they disappear entirely. As long as your phone stays away from sharp objects, you'll be just fine. A surprising number of people have watched my iPhone 6 camera lens replacement video, so let's find out why. The camera lens is actually made of sapphire glass, which is incredibly scratch resistant. You can see that my razor blade leaves absolutely no mark on the lens. Due to the extreme hardness of the lens, though, it leaves the circle of glass extremely brittle, and I can imagine that this is why so many people are looking into the camera lens replacements. It can handle sharp objects just fine, but the brittleness can't handle a hard drop. Replacing the glass lens, though, is actually pretty easy. You can check out that video if you're interested. Now, the glass screen of the iPhone 6 Plus was rather disappointing. The razor blade left some pretty hefty marks on the glass. Whether the blade is actually carving into the ion-strengthened glass or just the oleophobic coating, it's hard to know for sure. But either way, there are marks on the screen and they don't rub off. This is a sad day for Apple fans. Now the burn test. Not entirely practical, but still fun to watch. iPhones have an IPS LCD display, which does an awesome job of displaying colors. While the Super AMOLED Samsung screens might be more vibrant, I feel like the iPhone's IPS display are more true to life. Either way, they both stand up to heat about the same. The extreme heat from the lighter pretty much turns off the pixels until they cool down enough to turn back on, pretty much unaffected. You can see this same effect with the Samsung's AMOLED screens, as well as with the HTC and LG screens. I have videos where I burn all of these phones. Hit that subscribe button if you've liked what you've seen so far. Now onto the bend test. After the initial bending with my hands, you can tell that there is a slight curve to the body of the phone. This is not surprising and is pretty much old news with the whole Bendgate fiasco. What is surprising to me is how much pressure it took to get it to bend this much. When I applied the same amount of pressure to the HTC M9, which is HTC's most recent phone, it folded in half. So in reality, the iPhone 6 Plus is holding up much better than I expected. The minor initial bend could be straightened out pretty easily. But I'm not here to play patty cake with the iPhone though, so let's keep going. After a lot more pressure, I finally got the screen to break. The discoloration in the screen is most likely from the LCD ribbon cables ripping up along the top of the phone. It looks like the weakest points on the device are right where the buttons and the SIM card slots are along the edge. You can see a nice little crease from the bottom of the volume button all the way over to the SIM card itself. So if Apple wants to strengthen their phones in the future, they should probably focus on these points. Well, there you have it, the iPhone 6 Plus durability video. Feel free to check out some of my other durability videos that I've done with all of the latest phones. Let me know what you think down in the comments. What phone would you buy? Thank you for subscribing. Hope to see you around.